Hey brothers and sisters, how y'all doing? Hope you guys are doing fabulous. If you're new to my channel, welcome. My name is Michelle and I just wanted to come here really quickly and talk about my hair. If you guys have been watching my twist and tell videos, then you guys know that this year I've made it a point to try my best to take better care of my hair and actually like fall in love with it again. And in doing that, I've been going back and watching all these old school natural hair videos and just seeing how far along my hair has come. For those of you guys who don't know, I've been natural for 3 years now and I've had the most ups and downs, but I finally have gotten it right at this point and I know how to take care of my hair. So I'm not having any more issues with dryness. I'm not really having any issues with breakage. I got it down. So as always, I talk to you guys about my ups and my downs. I mostly talk about the things that I've made mistakes with so that you guys don't do it. Or if you do it, you don't feel like you're alone in it. But I also like to come here and air out frustration because a lot of times I realize as adults, we like to kind of put on a show like everything is cool, everything is fine, we got this. When really we do have frustration sometimes. Doesn't mean that we don't love our hair, doesn't mean that we don't advocate for our hair. It just means that we're human. And for me, I've noticed that a lot of times I want to wear my hair out. And the reason why I don't is because I can't trust it. I can't trust my hairstyles to come out looking the way that I want them to look. A lot of times when I work with my natural hair, the results are unpredictable, unreliable. And if I'm styling my hair, especially when I have somewhere really important to be and I want to look extra cute, I want to look like myself, so I want to wear my hair. And then the next day, the style comes out and I'm like, oh, I can't wear this. I cannot go out like this. And then that brings frustration. And then I have to figure out what I'm gonna do with my hair. So whether that's wear a wig or try to style it somehow in a hurry, that can get exhausting. And then it can also lead to you just not wanting to mess with your hair. So right now, that is my biggest problem with my hair, is that it's unreliable. So this year, my main goal is just to figure out how to ensure that my hair is always at least dry when I take it out, because that eliminates half of the issue. And then the other issue is just the style coming out as expected, but that has to do with learning how to like twist in a certain way, roll in a certain direction. Those are kind of mechanical things that I can figure out, but if I can just get the drying time to work out, that'll alleviate at least half of the issue. I must say overall though, I'm really happy with my hair. I know we've talked a lot about what I want to do with my hair as far as like styling it. There are a couple of things that I've been considering, and I appreciate all of your feedback because that is one of the things I'm also gonna consider. What you guys shared with me was to do the diva cut, which I think is cute. As you guys know, I was also considering doing like a classic afro because I think that's super cute. It's very reliable and it's very low maintenance, so I'm thinking about that as well. My biggest concern was I didn't wanna lose too much of my length. I've worked really hard to be able to retain it and I didn't want to lose too much of it. I don't mind losing some, but not, you know, I'm not going to go big chopping on you guys. Someone also mentioned me possibly doing locks. And interestingly enough, one day I actually did like a mini twist on my hair, and now that my hair is longer, I can kind of see how long it is now. It comes all the way down to here. So now that it's longer, I'm able to get, you know, some fall down, some length, and I was able to see what locks could look like. And it was cute. I liked it. I actually think that locks would suit me. I just don't know if I'm able to deal with the commitment of being locked into one hairstyle. Now, I know you can style the locks differently. I get that. But sometimes I just get in the mood to wear like a huge afro or sleek, straight, long hair. And that's the only reason why I'm not sure if I want to do locks, even though I know at some point in my life, I am definitely getting locks. One other thing that I thought about doing, but I'm not dyeing my hair again. I don't want to dye it, but I was thinking of getting like the sort of tapered look in the back. Right now, my hair, this is what the shape looks like, so it's kind of wild, but I'm thinking of getting it like a little bit lower in the back. I'll say like half of this, if I could just kind of lower it up a little bit. I would definitely want to keep the top high, and then I would want to just dye the tips of it a platinum blonde, like a white silver platinum blonde. I think that would be so pretty, but getting it that color will be tricky, and I don't want to go through that. A lot of these wig companies are starting to get real creative with their wigs, so I'm hoping that someone will come out with a really cute tapered afro and have the tips dye different colors. Outre, come on, Bobby Boss, one of you guys, I know you could do it. That would be so cute, and I would love a style like that. But I want to hear from you. Let me know, how do you guys deal with the frustrations of the unreliable hairstyles, especially if you have type 4 hair, type 4 C hair? Because y'all know, with this particular hair texture, you just never know. You guys always have great ideas. I want to hear from you, and I appreciate all of your support with me, with my channel, and just with my hair journey. You guys have been the most patient, supportive, all of that. Like, I love you guys, and nothing feels better than having gone through all the drama with you guys and now seeing my hair flourish. If I can do it, girl, you can do it too. I love you guys, and I'll see you in the next video. Big kisses. Mwah. Peace, love, and light.